Well, obviously, I'm a fan of Chet Baker. My birth name, Nick Murphy. There is another musician by the same name from Melbourne, actually, and he has two albums out. He might have three. I haven't checked in a while. But when I was starting, it was a small project in my garage. I didn't think it would go worldwide, you know. So I was just trying not to step on anyone's toes. So I thought, okay, I need another name, which I didn't really want to do. Which is kind of why the faker is in there. It's almost like a little dig at myself. Like, yeah, it's not my name, I know, you know. But yeah, I was listening to a lot of jazz. It was a new thing for me at the time. And Chet Baker, I like his music stylistically, but conceptually, I like the idea that Chet Baker represented for me. The idea that you didn't have to be technically amazing to make good music. And that you could actually take your flaws and make the music more powerful. So, you know, he wasn't a singer traditionally, he was a trumpet player. But when he started singing, I mean, you could say he sucked, but he didn't. The music was really good. And it was just like a big, like, oh wow, moment for me, because I always thought that a singer had to hit a high note or show you how good they were. But Chet Baker was the first musician for me that showed me that a song can just be a song without trying to invade you. It can just welcome you to the song. So that was a big, that was something that I wanted to do with my music.
It's
Since
like,
Chet Faker, you know.
well, it's like sometimes someone can be technically perfect, but they don't hit you in the heart. Like,
That's
that's
right.
something
Yeah,
different.
it's and you know, you can get lost in the technicalities or the empirical scientific side of music, but it is an art form. It's not a science at the end of the day. So it's about expressing human qualities, and imperfection is human as anything. So if you can express an imperfection confidently, people are going to relate to that.